Patients with hemophilia A need frequent prophylactic infusions of factor VIII to prevent bleeding in joints, soft tissue, and the central nervous system. Breakthrough bleeding with progressive joint destruction can further impair quality of life. In addition, about a third of patients develop antibodies to factor VIII replacement therapy that block its effects. This 52-week clinical trial tested a single intravenous infusion of adeno-associated virus factor VIII gene therapy in 9 adult men with severe hemophilia A. Patients were enrolled sequentially in low-dose, intermediate-dose, or high-dose cohorts. High-dose patients were also treated with a short course of glucocorticoids to minimize liver toxicity from the virus. In the low and intermediate dose cohorts, factor VIII levels remained low. In the high dose cohort, between weeks 2 and 9, factor VIII levels in all 7 patients reached the cutoff from mild to moderate hemophilia, and factor VIII in 6 of the 7 increased to normal levels, which were maintained after 1 year. In all 7 high-dose patients, after week 2, the median annualized bleeding rate decreased from 16 bleeds before the study to 0 bleeds. None of the 9 treated patients used any factor VIII for self-reported bleeds from week 22 to the end of the study period. Adverse events were considered minor. 8 of the 9 patients had mild elevations in serum ALT levels that resolved without sequelae. 1 patient had progression of pre-existing chronic arthropathy. The authors conclude that infusion of the high-dose vector-encoded factor VIII led to sustained normalization of factor VIII activity, with a significant reduction in bleeding events and factor VIII use in patients with severe hemophilia A. Although no serious safety events were noted, continued follow-up is needed to determine long-term safety and efficacy. Full trial results are available at nejm.org.